So after the stage of gastrula, the gastrula stage, the embryo now enters into the stages of larva. So larval formation starts after the stage of gastrulation. There are three larval stages seen in the life cycle of Asterius. The first larva that is formed soon after the process of gastrulation is called as dipleurula larva, also referred as early bipinnaria larva. Dipleurula larva or early bipinnaria larva. This is the first stage after gastrulation. The second larval stage is called bipinnaria larva. The third larval stage is called brachiolaria larva. So all together, there are three larval stages in the development of Asterius. Soon after the process of gastrulation, the three germ layers are formed. From all the three germ layers, there forms a larva called early bipinnaria or dipleurula. Students, remember, this particular stage of early bipinnaria dipleurula is a common larval stage for all echinoderms, including Asterius. So, in this particular stage, the larva becomes transparent. It is ovoidal in shape. It starts moving freely in the water. When it starts moving freely in the water, we make use of the term pelagic. So, free swimming larva, transparent larva, pelagic because it floats onto the surface of the water, and now the shape of it is ovoidal. There are no arms connected to the body structure. Instead, it has two major parts for the body. Number one, it has complete digestive canal. The digestive system starts from mouth, ends with the anus. It has mouth, esophagus, stomach, intestine, rectum and anus. Mouth parts, it starts with the mouth and ends with the anus. Digestive system is complete. And it is surrounded by, the body is surrounded externally by means of the ciliary bands. Ciliary bands are a long chain of cilia that is in the form of bands, which helps the animal in two processes. The larval stage is getting benefited by the ciliary bands with two processes. Number one, locomotion. So the animal starts freely moving in the water with the help of the ciliary band. Number two, it also assists in the phenomenon of getting the food for feeding. We call it as our ciliary band helping for the feeding process. So, swimming or locomotory process, number two for the feeding process, this ciliary bands are seen. So, we have complete digestive system, the ciliary bands are present, which is helpful for the body of the organism to have the process of locomotion as well as the feeding.